Hi everyone. Today we're going to talk about polycystic ovarian syndrome, or commonly called PCOS. I'm Dr. Leong from Alpha IVF. Now, a lot of women actually do have PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome, but they probably do not know that they have it until much later on. So today we're going to talk about it in a bit more detail, and also how it affects you as a woman, and also how it affects you in terms of your fertility. Now, in the first place, the diagnosis of PCOS is quite varied. It requires an ultrasound diagnosis, plus also some symptoms that you need to have. Now, in PCOS, mainly a few things will occur in your body, be it chemically, and also in the function of your reproductive systems. Basically, in general, PCOS is a spectrum of events, of spectrum of things that's happening in your body. You may not have everything in this spectrum, you may have bits and pieces of symptoms in this spectrum, or you may have the whole spectrum, all the symptoms. It doesn't really matter. You know, you have some of the symptoms of this spectrum, you are still considered to have PCOS. Now, in general, in PCOS, your body does not ovulate on time. Now, as a woman in your fertile age group, generally you will release one egg per month. You ovulate once a month. Now, in PCOS, that may not happen. Maybe there's totally no ovulation, or you may ovulate very, very late. Maybe once every 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, or maybe more. Therefore, because you do not ovulate on time, your period cycles will also be irregular. So theoretically speaking, if a woman ovulates on time every month, your period should come on time every month if you're not pregnant. So if you do not ovulate on time, or you have irregular ovulation, your periods may be delayed. You may have periods once every 2 months, once every 3 months, even more. Or every month is a totally different timing. You have no idea when your periods will come. Every month is a guesswork. So if you think you have this kind of symptoms, this kind of regular periods, you may have PCOS. So you may want to consult your OBGYN to have a quick check. Now, on top of having irregular ovulation times, some changes occur in your body as well, mainly hormonal changes. Because the hormone sequence in your body is not on track, because you do not ovulate regularly, so there'll be some not so good hormone changes in your body. Mainly your testosterone or your male hormone may be elevated. Now, you must understand, as a woman, even as a woman, you will have testosterone levels, male hormones, but in a very low amount. Now, in PCOS, this testosterone level will be elevated, plus other hormone imbalances. So mainly some women may experience very fast increase body weight. And you know, they can be taking care of what they eat or even exercising, but still they put on a lot of weight, unnecessary weight, normally around the tummy. So that could be because of PCOS as well. May have oily skin, problems with pimples. That's also one of the spectrum, one of the things that you may find in PCOS. Now, some women also have a bit of problems with excessive body hair, maybe facial hair, maybe around the tummy, on the arms and legs. So that also can be because of PCOS. If you are someone who is married and trying to have a child, it may cause you to have problems with trying to conceive, because of the fact that you're not ovulating on time, so it's very hard for you to get the right time for you to have a baby. In a nutshell, if you'd imagine that you ovulate once a month, so in a year you only have 12 fertile seasons in a year. So if someone with PCOS, maybe you ovulate once every 2 or 3 months, you can understand in a year you probably only have 3 or 4 fertile seasons in the entire year. So it's a bit harder to hit the fertile period to try a child, to have a child. So in this portfolio, in this category of women who have PCOS but they're not trying to have a child, not married, so sometimes you may need some hormonal treatment to regulate your periods. so that you can plan your lifestyle, your schedule properly, so that you know when you have a period. Also, in PCOS, in very bad cases of PCOS, those who have very irregular periods, you also tend to run a higher risk of getting some cell changes in your uterus. Well, what we call in medical terms as endometrial hyperplasia. What it means is that the cells in the uterus is not shedding out routinely from the period every month. So there may be changes where the growth of the cells is a bit too fast, too much growth in the cells in the uterus. That can predispose you to a higher risk of getting uterine cancer later on. So even if you're not trying to have to start a family, you may want to take hormonal therapy to regulate the periods, especially if you do not have a period for more than 3 months. So in order to prevent bad things happening in your uterus, any abnormal or bad cell changes in the uterus. So let's talk about PCOS and fertility. So as we have just mentioned, it is a bit difficult, more difficult for you to have a child because you are having PCOS, having irregular ovulation times. I'm not saying that it's impossible. It is going to be harder in very severe cases, maybe almost impossible. So in very mild cases, we can give you some pills, ovulation pills to promote ovulation, and the doctor can tell you when you are actually fertile and when you can try. In very severe cases, even with pills, you may not ovulate. So you may need things like injections and so on and so forth to help you out. Can you do without hormones to treat PCOS? Yes, you can. For most individuals, certain individuals, PCOS, you can even consider doing laparoscopic surgery. If you do some ovarian drilling, you may reactivate your ovaries and you may have regular periods and regular ovulation after that. And provided everything else is good, for example, you have no problems with your fallopian tubes, your husband's sperm is okay, you should have no problems getting a child or starting a family after that. Now, in cases where there may be multiple problems, for example, husband's sperm is also not that great or the tubes are blocked, on top of that you have PCOS, so you may need further fertility treatment.